Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. How are you? Hope all are you fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to our NIEBS home school. This is Sonia Khan Joya, assistant teacher of National Identity Version School, Morishif, Dhaka. Today I am going to take BGS class for the student of 9 students. And our today's topic is chapter 1, section 1.3. Again I am saying, and look at the board student. Again I am saying, our today's topic is chapter 1, section 1.3, lecture number 3, and homework number 2. Homework is 5 MCQ. So my dear student, let's start our today's topic. Look at the board student. This is chapter 1, section 1.3, the martial law and the subsequent political events. What is the name of the section 3? The martial law and the subsequent political events. As the West Pakistan was grouping under the ominous reign of the military and civilian rulers, the parliament as well as the government could not play any effective role. In the provincial assembly, deputy speaker Shahid Ali was seriously injured and subsequently died in a hospital. President Iskandar Mirza declared martial law on 7 October 1958 on the pretext of this contest. After assuming the power, the decisions he took were as follows. In 1958, Iskandar Mirza declared martial law on 7 October. And what is the... And he took some decision, and these are the decisions: annulled the constitution of 1956, dissolved the central and provincial assemblies, banned the political activities of the parties. Sheikh Mujib and some other leaders were arrested and sent to prison. All fundamental rights were suspended. These 5 decisions were took by Iskandar Mirza in martial law. In martial law, Iskandar Mirza took some decision. These were the 5 decisions. Then occupant power of Ayub Khan. General Ayub Khan as the president of Pakistan and to the following steps. In that time, General Ayub Khan was the president of Pakistan, and he took some following steps. Number one, declared himself the chief martial law administrator. Postponed the general election of 1959, declared earlier. Number three, expressed his commitment to weed out corruption and illegal trafficking of goods. Continue embargo on political parties. These are 4 following steps are taken by General Ayub Khan, the president of Pakistan in that time. Then discriminating attitudes to the people of East Pakistan. Then what is the discriminating attitude to the people of East Pakistan? East Pakistan started lagging behind due to the oppressive rule of West Pakistan. Discrimination between the 2 parties was looming large since then. Number one, discrimination in the economic sector, discrimination in the administrative sector, discrimination in the defense sector, discrimination in the education sector, and social discrimination. Now I describe this discrimination sector. Discrimination in economic sector is Pakistan received taka 113 crore 3,18,000 taka at the budget, and West Pakistan got 500 taka in the budget. Discrimination in the administrative sector. Yes, Pakistan was prevented from playing any effective role in the administration of Pakistan. Then defense sector. Bengalis were subjected to blatant discrimination in the recruitment and promotion system of the Pakistani Army, Navy and Air Force. And discrimination in the education sector, as Bengal was far ahead of West Pakistan in the primary and secondary education before the establishment of Pakistan. But when West Pakistan was established, East Pakistan was lag behind in the education system. Then number four, the anti-martial law movement. Agitation started in the East Pakistan against the autocratic reign of Ayub Khan since 1961. The students became vocal against the form of government proposed by Ayub Khan. Then they declared 15 point demands. Then the 15 point demand then he declared. Then background of the 6 point demands. Then start from anti-martial law movement, then start background of the 6 point demands. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman came up with the 6 point demands as the national charter for the liberation of the Bengalis from the oppression and torture by Ayub Khan regime. Okay, what is the 6 point demand? The 6 point demands is Bengal's charter of freedom. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman is the proponent of the historic 6 point demands. He stated the six point charter demands in a press conference to defend the rights of the people. The points are as follows. These six are 6 point movement. What is the six point demand? Number one, in Pakistan there will be the parliamentary form of government under federal system. Then number two, the central government will keep two ministries in their hand, and defense and the foreign affairs. Then number three, two different but convertible types of currency should be introduced in the country, or a single currency might be used on some terms and conditions. Then number four, the state government will preserve the right to impose tax collected revenue. Then number five, the states will be the owners of the foreign currency and a portion will be deposited to the treasury of the central government. Then number six, the states will be given the power of forming militia for their regional security. These six are six point movement demand. Then 6 point demand, after 6 point movement, then come the historic Agartala case, state vs Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and others. The historical Agartala case and this others name is this case, state vs Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and others. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman believed that the freedom would not be achieved without armed struggle. He gave consent to the revolutionary wing formed secretly to achieve independence. The revolutionary wing planned to attack all the cantonment being divided into different groups on a specific date at night in the commando style to snatch arms and ammunition from the Pakistani forces and hold them captive. With this plan in mind, Sheikh Mujib had once visited Agartala, the capital of Tripura, India, as the plan was disclosed before being martyrized. The historic Agartala state vs Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and others. A charge was framed against a total of 35 persons, Bangabandhu was named the number one defendant on the basis on the 6 and 11 point demands, the route among the masses and the subsequent historic Agartala case. Eventually encouraged the people to move for the independence. Mainly the historical Agartala case mainly against of Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and 35 person. And this this historical Agartala case other name is State vs Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. And this Agartala case eventually encouraged the people to move for the independence. Then the mass uprising in 1969. The most important movement against the Pakistani rulers was launched in 1969 with full participation by the all democratic parties. Professionals, people from all walks of life took part in the movement. Asaduzzaman Asad, a student of the University of Dhaka, and Dr. Shamsud Joha, a professor of the University of Rajshahi, became the victim of brutal killings by the Pakistani Janta. In the end of Ayub Khan was forced to release Sheikh Mujib unconditionally on 22 February 1969 on 23 February at the Racecourse ground, Chhatra Sangram Parishad gave a warm reception to Sheikh Mujib and he was awarded the title Bangabandhu. In 1969, the mass uprising were held and in that time Sheikh Mujibur Rahman released on 22 February. And on 23 February, Chhatra Sangram Parishad gave a warm reception to Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and he was awarded the title Bangabandhu. He was awarded the title of Bangabandhu in 1969 on 23 February. Then the historical influence of the mass uprising. Pakistani Janta Ayub was forced to resign as the consequence of the mass uprising 1969. Before his resignation, he withdrew the Agartala case. The new military government of General Yahya was forced to declare the general in 1970. The mass uprising of 1969 had an influence in the polling of 1970 and the liberation war of 1971. The influence of mass uprising that 1917 election and 1971 liberation war. The election of 1970 and aftermath. Finally, on 7 December 1970, the general election was held for the first time in Pakistan on the basis of one person, one vote. The Awami League, the NAB, the Muslim League, the Pakistan People's Party, the Democratic Party, Jamaat-e-Islam and some other parties took part in the election. In the Central Parliament election of 1971, the Awami League begged 167 seats out of 169 seats preserved for East Pakistan. In the election of Provincial Assembly held on 17 December, the Awami League got 298 out of 30 seats and won the absolute majority. And the importance of the election of 1970, the significance of the election in emerging and independent Bangladesh in 1971 became clear. It also played a vital role to transfer the spirit of nationalism to the spirit of freedom. So my dear student, in section 1.3 there are many important points, that power of Ayub Khan, then discriminating attitude to the people East Pakistan, then anti-martial law movement, 6 point demands, and the 6 point, what are the 6 point demands, these are the six point demands, then the historic Agartala case, And this historic Agartala case, other name is State V.A. Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Then the mass uprising in 1969, the historical influence of mass uprising and the election of 1970. And dear student, your homework number 2 and 5 MCQ. You will do 5 MCQ from this section 1.3. So my dear student, I hope all of you students have understood today's topic and will do your homework, and your homework is from section 3 5 MCQ. You will do 5 MCQ from section 1.3 and will do your homework and will submit Saturday. Allah Hafiz.